Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the 7th BGICC, the Breast Gynecological International Cancer Conference, and the best to start with is the Holy Quran.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الله
نور السماوات والأرض مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة يوقد من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء
Now, I guess you're about the only person around that doesn't have TV coverage of the scene. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for man. Oh, that looks beautiful to me, Neil.
Who owns the patent on this vaccine?
Well, the people, I would say, there is no patent.
Generation.
6 years ago, we started organizing what I believe was the first ever academically oriented conference in the Middle East, focusing on promoting optimal standards of care for patients with breast and gynecological cancer. One aim of the BGICC is to provide the global platform to share and communicate experiences and research in cancer and the status of the problems facing the breast in the region and in global level. This global perspective is supported by a very important organizations like the ASCO, ESMO, ESSO, and ESO. This year, the conference is held owing the Nobel Prize and Nobel Care of and under patronage of His Excellency Professor Adil Adawi, Minister of Health and Population, and His Excellency Professor Sharif Hamad, Minister of Scientific Research, and His Excellency Professor Hussein Naissa, President of Ain Shams University, who support this activity very much year after year. And also, this conference is under the patronage of Professor Abdul Wahab Izzat, Vice President of Ain Shams University, and Dr. Ahmed Ahmed Din Radi, the Dean of Faculty of Medicine, Ain Shams University. My dear professor, Professor Hussein Khaled, the honorary president of the conference, who is the past minister of higher education, one of the greater support for the conference since it started, and he is the godfather of the medical oncology in Egypt. Thank you, Dr. Hussein, and I ask you to give us a talk.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good morning, everybody. I'm very honored and pleased to accompany you in this very important scientific event of Egypt. You know, the cancer is a global problem. It is the second cause of mortality after cardiovascular diseases. And in Egypt, we now have the first national, population-based national cancer registry, where five governorates are representing the whole country now, and we have incidence rates. You used to have frequency rate, now we have incidence rates for cancer, and the most common male cancer is liver cancer, representing 39 new cases per 100,000 normal population per year, while breast cancer is number one among females, representing 35 new cases per 100,000 normal population per year. And for the whole country, the incidence rate of cancer is 113 new cases per 100,000 normal population per year. This breast cancer meeting is very important one. You see, all participants are from all over the country, from the cancer centers, from the cancer departments, and the governmental universities, from the National Cancer Institute, from the NGOs, from everywhere. And of course, we are very delighted to have the highbrow scientists from European and United States. I hope they will enjoy their time also in Egypt. Egypt now is a safe country. You can go around, you can see everything in the country. For those who came for the first time, please visit at least the attractions in Cairo. I also welcome our brothers and Arab colleagues from many countries around. And I hope a success for this meeting. Professor Hisham Al Ghazali is one of the eminent professors of oncology in the country. I hope and I thank him very much for very clear success of this important meeting. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Hussein. He now has a commitment with the Minister of Health. So it is the time for Professor Abdul Wahab Izzat, who is supporting this conference. He is the Vice President of Ain Shams University. He's a great surgeon, and as a surgeon, he usually takes sharp decisions and usually supporting the scientific activity like this.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم بحيي حضراتكم جميعا وبحيي السادة المنصة الكرام On behalf of the president of Anshans University, Professor Hussein Issa, I'd like to welcome you all, guests and colleagues, in the opening session of this 7th Breast Gynecological International Cancer Conference, which is held annually here in Egypt, and it is one of the biggest conferences concerned with this subject. As I see from the agenda of the conference, there is a lot of scientific activities in this conference concerned with the most recent modalities in the diagnosis and the treatment of those diseases. There is a lot of work concerned with workshops, education sessions, and courses for surgical oncology, for gynecology, for radiotherapy, pathology, and so on. And really, it's a lot of work to be done in 2 days, and I hope that you have, inshallah, valuable discussions and productive discussions and conclusions, and enjoyable stay in Egypt, inshallah. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Abdulwahab Izzat. And Professor Nadia Zakhari, the past Minister of Research, of the Scientific Research, supporting a lot, and usually she is dedicated. She is a professor of biology, firstly, and so we are very interested to have her support in the scientific research and on cancer research, especially.
Good morning, everybody, dear excellence and dear colleagues. It's my pleasure to be here among you. It's a very important topic, which is the breast cancer, because its frequency ranks represent 32% among the total malignancy. Really, a lot of scientific research had been done in this field, but we never benefit of this scientific research that we are doing. We are still applying all the traditional modes throughout. So we need to collect all these scientific researches that have been done and find what is promising to apply. We also have to make a sort of early diagnosis and prevention, and to know what is the exact cause of breast cancer and how can we make awareness throughout the country. And for the ladies, how to make their own diagnosis and so on. It's our duty and our job to make this awareness for the people. Our duty to find out new medications and new modalities of the therapeutic modalities. And this needs the approval of the laws of preclinical and clinical studies. I hope all the success for this conference and all good ideas that will be the recommendations. We can apply the recommendations that will come out of this conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Professor Nadia. And it's my honor to introduce one of the iconic professors in oncology, Professor Yasser Abdel Eder, Professor of Clinical Oncology at Cairo University. He is the conference president and supporting this scientific activity a lot. Professor, yes.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm usually the last speakers because of my name. Why? Bottom of the list. Anyway, good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and allow me to thank the organizers of this important international meeting, and top of the list of the organizers is my friend or my young brother, Professor Hisham Al-Ghazali, who gave me actually this nice opportunity and honor to be here with you. Distinguished speakers, distinguished professors, and distinguished attendees. Allow me again to welcome all our honorable guests from the States, from the Arab region, and from Europe. I'm full of hope that we all, as oncologists, surgical oncologists, radiation oncologists, medical oncologists, to share some points of view in order to reach an ideal solution, ideal guidelines that could cooperate with our countries, I mean Egypt and Arab countries, and to reach well agreed upon treatment, breast cancer treatment guidelines, and all kinds of gynecological or female cancers. Again, I'm welcoming you here in our beloved country, Egypt. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Yasser. And now on the Professor Rabab Ghaffar. She is one of the most important scientists and researchers in Egypt, and she is a professor of medical oncology, NCI, and the ESMO national representative. Professor Rabab.
Thank you very much, Professor Hashem. In fact, as a national representative and panel member of ESMO, I would like to congratulate the group of BGICC and all organizers and Professor Hashem El-Ghazali for an excellent annual accredited and recognized meeting by most of the societies, and I specify ESMO. Why ESMO? The European Society of Medical Oncology is the leading European professional organization committed to advancing the specialty of medical oncology and promoting a multidisciplinary approach to cancer treatment and care. Now, according to recent data from ESMO, where is Egypt on the map? Egypt, as regards membership, Egypt is among the top 10 countries. We rank number 6 after USA, Germany, Italy, Switzerland, and UK, and we have membership 411 in the year 2014. As regards the fellowship program, Africa participated like 124 candidates, of them 15 fellowships were accepted, and Egypt has of them 9. So we were among the top 5 fellowship programs between 2007 and 2014. And we cannot forget that this year, during the ESMO meeting, there was an award for the fellowship of Dr. Hatem Abdelazim, who received his fellowship and his PhD through the ESMO. And then, where is Egypt regarding the ESMO exam? We are among the top 5 for the exams with 41 candidates in 2014, and the only 2 countries allowed outside Europe for this exam were in Egypt and in India. So this ESMO certificate proves that the candidate has satisfactorily met the criteria of excellence according to ESMO, which is the highest European society in this field. So finally, I would like to wish you an excellent stay in Egypt, a very, very successful meeting, and many social activities in a very safe country, which is Egypt now. And I thank you very much. And thanks again for the BGICC group and Professor Hashem El-Ghazali.
Thank you very much, Professor Rabab. And it is my honor to introduce my dear professor, Professor Heba Zawahri, the immediate past chairman of the Medical Oncology Department, the NCI, and the one who supported this activity from its beginning in 2009. Professor Heba.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good morning, everybody. Dear professor and colleague, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure and honor for me to introduce and announce for the 7th Breast and Gynecological International Conference. And I saw the beginning, the very first beginning of the first one, and I know and I knew how much the effort, time, and the tedious work have been done to organize such conference. And now this is the 7th, and we all in Egypt and in Cairo honor to have our guests from the Arab region, from the Mediterranean region, as well as from USA. We are honored to have many professors that share with us the very updated treatment for breast cancer and gynecological cancer. I know that this conference is very important for the junior people because there is a lot of educational session, and for the intermediate generation because there is a lot of update, and for the senior people like me because there is some recommendation how to treat and how to treat particular our patient on the region. Please join every activity, discuss, and provoke your routine and clinical sense. This is very important to all of us, and this is very healthy. My congratulations to Professor Hisham Al-Ghazali and his team for his continuous, tedious work, and hope for him many and future success. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Heba, and it is my honor to introduce one who is usually supporting, one who is the introducing the multidisciplinary approach in gynae cancer. Professor Magid Abu Saada is the man who supported this conference and the gynae part of it from its start since 7 years. Professor Magid, please.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Good morning, everybody. I have nothing to be said after what have been said, but I hope this conference, with a great effort of Professor Hisham Al-Ghazali, will be, as usual, fruitful and beneficial for whom are interested in the field of breast tumors and gynecological tumors. I hope the whole success for this meeting, and I hope for all the attendees to find the meeting fruitful and to share knowledge with experts in this field. And I hope for the dear guests a nice stay in Cairo and a fruitful visit for Egypt. And thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Magid. And it is my honor now to introduce my boss, Professor Imam Fuad, Head of Clinical Oncology Department at Shams University and the BGICC President. Professor Imam working very hard to build a reputable image and a strong scientific portfolio to our department and with unrestricted support for all the scientific activity. Thanks for Dr. Imam.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, dear colleagues and dear professors. I'm speaking on the behalf of the Clinical Oncology Department, Ain Shams University, and I have the honor to be with you today and to be invited in the opening ceremony. I wish to thank all the organizing committee for the continuous effort and for their commitment to provide us with the successful annual meeting as always. And I think this conference is one of the best regional conferences in the field of the breast and the gynecology malignancies. Also, I would like to thank all the experts who are coming from all over the world to give us their experience and updates. I would like to thank our leaders, Professor Dr. Abdel Wahab Izzat, for coming today and for his continuous support for all the efforts are done in our department. Finally, I would like to thank all our colleagues and all our professors who are coming from over Egypt and Arabs to participate in this conference, and I wish they will enjoy their stay in Egypt, and many thanks.
Thank you very much, Professor Iman. And I cannot express my thank and gratitude to our unique, very high caliber international faculty who drew the roadmap of cancer treatment in the world. Actually, I'm very honored by their participation here in this conference, and this conference cannot be done without them. Thank you for the effort, for their effort, and I hope to enjoy this beautiful country. And I'm feeling proud that the conference started 2009 with the presence of 300 participants, and this year